story of this important government service started in the U.S. Patent Office. There, Commissioner Henry Ellsworth felt that to protect the interests of the farmer, it was the government's responsibility to provide the Congress with reliable information on the harvest. His was the first crop report. Fourteen years later, when government interest in crop reports had waned, the farmers themselves attempted to supply the sorely needed agricultural information through their own organizations. James T. Earle of the Maryland Agricultural Society attempted to gather national information on the crops, as he put it, to guide all farmers as to the best time to dispose of the fruits of their labors. But Earle failed to receive cooperation from other state societies. Next to try crop reporting was farm editor Orange Judd, but his magazine also found the job too big. This helped toward the establishment of the Department of Agriculture in 1862 and regular crop reports. Through the years, many forces have helped shape American crop reporting into a valuable service. There was increasing immigration, homesteading, and westward expansion. The new iron horse, which never tired of hauling crops. Waterways, which brought agricultural produce from newly opened lands. Drastic effects due to booms and depressions. A succession of global wars with their hungry aftermath. And an ever-growing American market approaching 200 million people. People who must be constantly supplied. Today, the Agricultural Marketing Service publishes reliable reports that give current estimates of production, stocks, labor, and prices. This wide variety of crop reports is released on a regularly scheduled basis for the benefit of all. Users of the services include farmers' organizations where one man passes along to his neighbors information that helps them plan their crop production, producers' cooperatives. These farmers depend on honest reports timed to each season and complete as to condition and probable yield of the crops. Railroads and other carriers instruct their dispatchers to use the reports as a guide to allocating freight cars and trucks to transport the nation's crops. State and county extension workers. In their hands, the reports play an important part in helping farmers decide what to plant, where, and when. Legislators use the reports to serve American interests at home and abroad. Then there are the processors and handlers, a long list of farm product buyers and sellers from coast to coast who constantly follow and use crop and livestock reports. Don't forget the credit agencies and the busy exchanges. The impartial reports also aid the banks in servicing the farmers' needs. Directly as well as indirectly, all crop reports benefit the farmer. Today, the service accurately gauges the strength and well-being of all the country in terms of food, feed, and fiber. Behind the doors of the field offices, financed jointly by federal and state funds, crop reporting starts with the mailing of questionnaires. Since America's tremendous agricultural output is the total production of about 4.5 million individual farms, the farmers themselves, through the mail, provide the bulk of the information. Rural free delivery supplies the most economical and rapid means of obtaining the answers to questions addressed to individual farmers. In addition, mail carriers across the country distribute about 2 million unaddressed questionnaires every year. At most farms, in return for his help, the farmer receives published reports to guide him in his farming operations. Timely and reliable information is important to men like Jim Baldwin. For timely information on acreage that farmers countrywide expect to plant to various crops, Jim Baldwin relies on the latest published Intentions to Plant report. And so Jim Baldwin decides. In the same way, crop reports help all farmers steer a course to more efficient production. Although there are hundreds of different questionnaires, the voluntary reporters answer only the few that apply to their particular farms or communities. In the case of soybeans and other oil-bearing crops, the producer is asked to report number of acres planted, as well as production and disposition. There's a monthly hatchery report, which inquires into incubator capacities, eggs set, chicks and poults hatched, and prices. Dairy farmers report number of cows, production of milk, and feeding practices to help them follow changing conditions in the industry. Information on farm feedlots is obtained through the inquiry, which asks number of cattle, hogs and sheep on feed, and in some cases, intentions to market. Wheat inquiries obtain information on the crop from the time of fall seeding through winter hazards, additional spring planting, harvest, and disposition. Estimates are made of vegetable crops, which the producer sells through the fresh market or to processors for freezing and canning. Basic information used for monthly estimates of farm employment is collected by mail from crop reporters on the monthly farm report and by personal interview. It covers persons employed, family workers, and the number of hours they work. Certain livestock inquiries ask for sheep numbers and wool production. Information is also furnished by meat slaughterers and other primary processors and handlers. Mills and elevators supply data on stocks of grain that have already left the farm. Dairy processing plants report production. Ginners contribute information on farmers' marketing. Government agencies provide data like the supply of water for irrigation. Back to the state offices now come the filled-out questionnaires from the farmers, from the specialized producers and processors, and from the private and government agencies, all users of and contributors to the most complete crop reporting service in the world. Individual reports are combined into state totals and averages for the agricultural statistician, a scientist by training, and a farmer at heart. Now the statistician has to make the best possible interpretation of the collected data in the light of experience and the current situation. To ensure accuracy,